So when I noticed that something was amiss, I said, stop all the payments. I think we had paid like, maybe was it 2,000-3,000? I can't remember now. We had just started paying. I said, I told my team, stop all the payment. I said, something fishy is happening. That was when we realized that those Abure's people, the Labour Party, had given us fictitious names. Most of the names there weren't the names that were supposed to be there. They had been changed. Yes, I am saying this. If they want to go to court, please let us all meet in the court. We started paying on the day of election. We started paying, what do you call it now, the polling unit agents. Then something was amiss. Remember, people started saying they were not seeing polling unit agents in their places. So we now, okay, randomly, let's call some of the numbers that we had. We're calling numbers. You will call someone, maybe the name is male, a female is answering, or is female, a male is answering, and they're asking you, they don't know what you're talking about. What polling unit agent, what this, what's that? It was like magic. And immediately, I said to my team, I said, stop payment. Yes, I did. On the issue of the party agents, yes, I was in charge of party agents. On the day of election, after they finally gave us the party agents list, because we were tight, this thing had come, they didn't give us the list on time. I think it was 24 hours to the election that they finally gave us the list. I don't even know whether they gave the other ones or I was the one that sent it to them. And so we needed to send bulk SMS. So we sent bulk SMS to 130 something, is it 36 or 39,000 polling unit agents, asking them, we said to them, send us your account numbers. Send us your account numbers. We got some, I think, was it about 5,000 or less than 5,000 that, you know, sent in the account, their account details. On the day of election, we had set up everything. We started paying. On the day of election, we started paying, what do you call it now, the polling unit agents. Then something was amiss. Remember, people started saying they were not seeing polling unit agents in their places. So we now, okay, randomly, let's call some of the numbers that we had. We're calling numbers. You will call someone, maybe the name is male, a female is answering, or is female, a male is answering, and they're asking you, they don't know what you're talking about. What polling unit agent, what this, what's that? It was like magic. And immediately I said to my team, I said, stop payment. Yes, I did. So when I noticed that something was amiss, I said, stop all the payments. I think we had paid like, maybe was it 2,000-3,000? I can't remember now. We had just started paying. I told my team, stop all the payment. I said, something fishy is happening. That was when we realized that those Abure's people, the Labour Party, had given us fictitious names. Most of the names there weren't the names that were supposed to be there. They had been changed. Yes, I am saying this. If they want to go to court, please let us all meet in the court. Names had been changed. I've never spoken about this publicly because I just felt, whatever has happened, the same. We found that the names that were on that list were not the names that were supposed to be. Names had been changed. And what they did on election day was that they now started sending to me list of people that I was going to pay them. This one here, 200 million, of that 100 million, 50 million here. Amo, you see these politicians where you they see, so the way they call money millions here in politics, you'll be thinking, is it this money that we work hard together? These people are calling anyhow like this. Oh, send this one to this, send 200 million to this, send this thing to them. And I said, no, I'm not going to send it. On that election day, if pressure and calls and everything can kill somebody, I would have been dead by now. I refused to budge. I remember my husband coming to meet what he said, sweetheart, don't you think this thing, let them not say that. Let them not come and start accusing you that it's because of you that Peter Obi did not win election. I said, baby, the right thing has to be done, you know. Anything that me, I'm going to be, it has to be done. Pressure, calling here. I said, didn't budge. My husband said, no problem. He supports me, I know that. Later, it was in the afternoon or towards evening. Mr. Peter Obi spoke with me. And then I said, Pio, we have a problem. I said, with the agents that we're supposed to have, they are not there. They are not there on the street, and they are asking me to send money to people. Okay, let me even add, there's something I've forgotten to add. Why, when they were telling me that I should send lump sum of money to different, I have the names that they sent me. If I go back to the WhatsApp messages that I will receive, that were being sent to me. And I said, because I said to them, share it is agents you are going to pay. And you know that time it was the cash, there was that cashless, what happened, that change of money, redesign of Naira that CBN, MFLA CBN were doing, right? And so I said, there's no money. I said, say you people are going to transfer to the agent. I said, we from here, we will transfer to the agents. So you don't need to bother yourself and do the work. In election, that this is not the way election is done. In election, nobody asks questions. I said, well, you are not doing the normal election you normally do. Who will ask questions? That's why we want a new Nigeria. If you wanted Nigeria to continue the way where you will not ask questions, they would have simply stayed at home and sleep and allowed the people that already destroyed Nigeria to continue to destroy Nigeria. That was what I said to them. There was one particular place where someone asked me, okay, well, that was after the election, we were in a meeting. Okay, Aisha, how did you think you're going to stay in Abuja and then you'll be in charge of the agents? You'll be able to know the agents that are in Sokoto or other states. I said, through their phone numbers. Because every agent, there was a phone number. And then, you know the funny thing, what the person said to me? He said, but some of these agents cannot read and write. And I said, if they cannot read and write, how did they become our agents? There was silence in that meeting when I said, how, if they can't read and write, how are they our agents? How would they know if figures are changed or not? That was the end of that conversation. So what you had were fictitious name and they wanted to. So let me take you back to when Mr. Peter Obi called. Can't remember whether it was one that called me. I called me. I can't even remember. I think it was one that called. And so I said, Pio, there's fire on the mountain. I said, the agents that we're supposed to have, they are not there. Obidience brought in names. Obidience were ready to be agents, not to be able to be paid. But yet, names were brought in, names were switched. And they are coming out to say today that they did not take part in campaign fund collection. You think you are in 1900? Where you can lie and get away with it. You don't know that the internet never forgets. And so when I told people, I said, there's fire on the mountain. Oh, the agents, most of the agents that they say they are not there. You know what people said? He said, Aisha, keep my money. I'm like, yes, boss. Your money is well protected.